Hello everyone! Good evening, good morning, or good afternoon to you, whatever time you are watching us from. And we are Connie and Belle, and we are building a God-centered, purpose-driven life and freelancing business. By the way, our topic for today's session is all about how to never run out of content ideas for your social media. So, si Sisbel, nasanay na atang hindi ko pinagsasalita sa umpisa kasi nakamute pa rin siya. Pero bago yan, ayan si Sisbel, ikaw na lang mag-opening prayer bago ako, baka makalimutan ko pa.
Okay, let's remember that we're in the presence of God, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, we praise you, we glorify you, we honor you, we thank you for blessing us this past few days. We're grateful for all the resources and the people you're sending our way so we can bless others and do what you called us to do. We ask for forgiveness and for every wrongdoing we committed. We lift up to you every person who is watching and listening to this podcast. We pray that you open their hearts and minds so that whatever we share with them will create an impact on their businesses. We'll also lift up to you, Connie and I, as well as our special guest for tonight. Pour out your Holy Spirit in us so we'll continue to have the courage to say the right words, to share what you're teaching us with the goal of telling your truth. Help and remind us, including our brothers and sisters, that we're building and thriving in our businesses to glorify you and serve the people we work with. We believe that whatever success we have, we owe it all to you. All this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Ayan, again, our topic for today's session is all about how to never run out of content ideas for social media. Super applicable, not just for the clients, pero sa atin din as freelancers. Ayan, if you're watching us for the very first time, make sure that you click that subscribe button as well as the bell to get notifications because we usually go live. As if sa siguro sa mga ibang videos na nakikita nyo, we usually go live every Monday and Thursday, 9 p.m. Manila time. And Sis Belle will share with us what we do during those days.
Yeah, so every Monday, we do our live praise and worship session. So we're encouraging everyone, if you're not doing anything on a Monday night, samahan nyo na lang kami mga kapatid. mag-praise and worship session tayo Monday night, 9 p.m. And then Thursdays, Connie and I talk more about freelancing, about digital marketing, about our work as virtual assistants. So if you're interested to learn more about the work that we do or any freelancing industry that you're interested to learn more about, catch us live every Thursday. Like ngayon, meron kaming interviewin about social media, right? So yes. Iba-ibang guest to. So mga kapatid, Thursdays, 9 p.m. Manila time.
Yes, and speaking of virtual assistant, if you need guidance, why not visit my book and get more information to start your virtual assistant business? Visit conniezabala.com/VA book. Available ang print, ebook, Kindle, at audiobook copy. So go ahead. If, ito pa, isa pa. Isang call to action pa ulit. If curious ka pa, ayaw mo pa rin bumili, go ahead and check the free chapter by visiting bit.ly/VA free chapter. O yan. If hindi nag-work, let me know lang. If di nyo pa nakuha, let me know. Send me a message. Ayun. O sige na, Sis Belle, introduce mo yung special guest natin.
Naka-excite. So tonight's special guest is a graduate with honors in tourism. Diba? Having achieved the distinction of summa cum laude. However, she decided to listen to her heart's desires and take on a different path. Today, she finds herself thriving as an Instagram content strategist, utilizing her skills and expertise. Her story is a testament of courage, determination, and the power of following one's true passion. So without further ado, let's all welcome Ms. Hannah Tobias. Tobias, pag Pilipino.
hello everyone.
Welcome to our YouTube channel. And again, salamat for saying yes to the invitation. So bago kami magtanong-tanong, short story muna. Actually, may follow-up na ako kasi summa cum laude, parang curious.
Wow!
Paano nangyari na ang summa cum laude ay nag-end up sa... freelancing world and offered social media. Ayan. Ano ba ang story?
Actually, sobrang unexpected po kasi pandemic po nun. So, browse lang ng phone, wala pong social life, walang hindi lumalabas. And then I came across this post about freelancing nga daw po na you can work at home and then you can earn. So, na-curious po ako. So, after po nun, as in, nagbabasa po ako, no, nagkoconsyo po ako ng mga videos about freelancing. And then, parang naengganyo na po ako. And then, fast forward po, parang nagka-chance mag-work from home po ako. So, I decided to apply as a call center agent para po maka-consume ng course po, which is paid course. Kasi although maraming free resources out there sa YouTube, mga free webinars, parang mas gusto ko po yung merong mentor. Mas nag-work po sa akin yung may coach directly. So, yun po. So, pinag-ipunan ko po talaga. And then, hanggang sa nagustuhan ko po yung kung ano yung laman ng course. So, after graduation, doon na po ako, what's next? San bang path? Ganon. So, after po nun, honestly, meron na po akong job offer nun sa OJT. Kung saan ako nag-OJT, which is Provincial Tourism Government na po ng Tarlac. And then, I also applied na rin po for ground staff sa NAIA. Actually, for final contract na po ako, I mean, final signing na po. Pinapadala na po yung requirements ko and all. Saturday po, nag-apply. And then, Monday, pinapabalik na po. And then, hindi po talaga ako tumuloy kasi, yun nga po, actually, hindi pa po tapos yung course ko nun. Parang, ang end po nun, nag-graduate po ako July. And then, ang end po ng course is December. So, I had to decide. Kasi kapag nag-go po ako sa work, hindi ko na ma-focus yung course. So, yun po. So, pinili ko po yung course, which is freelancing. Yun.
Parang follow-up, ayun na nga, di ba? Given na ito, grabe yung, I mean, yung na-receive mo na achievement ng studies mo eh. Kumusta reaction ng mga pamilya?
Yes, oo, yung family. Like, ayun nga eh, I'm sure marami kasi hindi nakakaintindi pa about
actually. Ano, yun po yung struggle ko ngayon, like kapag nalaman nila na sa bahay lang ako or wala ako sa expected nila kasi kapag graduate ka ng tourism, automatic labas ka ng Tarlac kasi ang pinakamalapit lang naman is Clark and Manila. So, nakikita nila ako dito sa Tarlac. Paano nangyari? Wala ka bang ginagawa or something? Na-afford po ako actually. Pero, yun nga po, ang sinasabi ko naman sa sarili ko na as long as at the end of the day, ako din naman yung nasa sa akin naman yung decision. Like, medyo awkward lang po minsan, freelancer ako. Ano yun? Parang kailangan ko mag-explain. Medyo hit ko po kasi nag-explain as an introvert po. So, yun po. Pero as long as okay naman po sa akin and okay po sa parents ko, yun na lang po yung pinangahawakan ko.
At least okay na sa parents yun naman talaga.
Yeah.
Grabe.
Sis, sorry ha, parang hindi yata sabay, sa akin lang ba, hindi sabay yung audio ni Hannah sa video?
Actually po, medyo naglalag.
Ah, okay. Baka makatulong kung may i-close kang ibang app siguro or something.
Sige. While waiting for that, for our viewers, feel free to ask your questions in the comments. Live tayo, hindi to pre-recorded. So we want to from you.
Oh, ayan. Itong topic na to. Kasi even, no, parang bago siya na, ano, syempre, marami makaka-relate.
Yes, ayan. So, ito na tayo. Dako na tayo sa mga questions natin. Do you integrate new technologies into your freelance career to stay competitive? How? Ayan.
Actually po, opo. Kasi kapag hindi ko po in-integrate, mapag-iiwanan po ako. So, ang pinaka-help po talaga nung technology is yung efficiency. So, for example po, yung content scheduling po, as in, hindi na po yung araw-araw kailangan upo ka sa laptop, tapos schedule ng content mo, schedule pa ng content ng client mo. And then, other things is, for example, yung sa mga analytics po, yung mga sa analytics and insights ng competitors para may basis ka, parang data-driven pa rin yung report mo. Hindi lang, ito yung strategy ko kasi ganyan, pero walang basis. So, yung meron kasing mga tool na nandun na agad, hindi na kailangan na manually titignan mo sa Instagram, back and forth pa, TikTok. Merong minsan scheduling tools na, or mga insights or analytic tools na nandun na lahat. Pero yung, ang mahirap lang minsan is medyo paid sila. Yung mga, for example, complete package, medyo premium rate sila. Unlike kapag free naman, medyo limited lang. Yun lang yung medyo downside nun. Kung scaling ka, okay yun. Pero pag startup ka, talagang imamanual mo.
Pero ano, yan, follow up. Since sinabi mo yung mga usually paid siya, sinasuggest mo ba yan sa clients na if ever mag-invest sila or sinasali mo yan sa offer mo? Like for example, before kayo mag-sign in, mag-close, ganyan, na kasama na siya, ganun.
Actually, yung price ko po is included na dun yung mga investment ko sa mga tools. So, minsan hindi ko naman na outright sinasabi na client mag-invest tayo. Ako mismo naka-invest na and then nakasama na siya dun sa rate na ibibigay ko sa client ko. Or kapag magtatanong naman siya, dun ko po explain kung ano yung mga paid tools and para saan yung mga yun.
Ayun.
Magandang tip yun, mga kapatid.
Yes. Para hindi na ano, sama nyo na sa package nyo. Para hindi niya makita as additional ano, bayad pa yan. Ayan. Medyo delayed pa rin ano.
Pero malinaw yung audio niya.
Oo. Malinaw nga eh. Ano lang, live kasi tayo mga kapatid. So, as long as malinaw ang audio niya at kita nyo naman yung face, gumagalaw pa rin naman. May pagka, ano lang talaga, delayed. Anyway, next question. Are there any tips you can suggest to build and maintain strong relationships with your clients?
Number one po siguro yung be honest lang kay client. Kasi nagkaroon ako ng client na pro bono, which is in-offer ko sa kanya yung service ko for free. And then sinabi ko na wala pa talaga akong experience. Pero I'm confident na matutulungan kita based doon sa mga napag-aralan ko sa current course ko ngayon. Kasi nagkaroon ako ng pro bono client, hindi pa ako tapos doon sa course. So parang tinake ko talaga siya as an opportunity for learning. Pero sinabi ko kay client. So na-appreciate niya yun. Mas na-appreciate nung client kapag honest ka. And then siguro yung second is yung collaboration siguro. Siguro set expectation lang din kay client na sabihin mo na itong project na to is more of a collaboration na hindi ako employee or lahat ng sasabihin niya lang yun lang yung susundin ko. So magpe-present ako, pwede siyang magsabi ng suggestion niya and then I'll say my, as an expert, I'll say my insights or my opinion and then doon magka-come up nung pinaka-strategy. So I think yun po yung pinaka nag-work bakit okay kami nung naging client ko.
Oh, ayan na naman.
Wow. Magandang tip 'yon, yun kasi 'di ba yung maraming mga aspiring freelancers. O saan kami mag-a-apply? Sino yung boss? Yung lagi naming na-mention ni Sis Cons, 'di ba? It's not an employer-employee na relationship yung tina-target natin as freelancers. Parang isipin niyo na business din kayo na nakikipag-collaborate with another business. So yung inputs nyo are very much ano talaga appreciated at yun yung binabayaran ng client na nakatrabaho natin. So yun, maganda yung ano na yun, yung mindset na share ni Miss Hannah.
Tsaka yung honesty kasi lahat naman tayo nag-umpisa sa zero, so alam nila yun. Ang ano lang siguro is kung sino yung client na tatanggap, which is meron talaga na client na tatanggap na welcome mag-trial, ganyan. So, huwag matakot. Ito pa yung isang na-observe ko. Hindi niya pa tapos yung course.
Nga eh. Galing, di ba? Oh, tamaan ang tamaan. Yung iba dyan, nakailang course na. Course hoarding na. Na shiny object syndrome.
Oh, kaya alam niyo na, hindi kailangan. Kumbaga, apply as you learn na agad, lalo na kapag yun na agad yung pinapagawa sa'yo. Gawin nyo na, wag nang hintayin. Kasi minsan nawawala yung momentum.
Yeah.
Ayun. Ito. Looking back at your freelance journey, what project or accomplishments are you most proud of and why?
Actually, yun yung nabanggit ko na yung first client ko kasi as in, first time ko sa lahat ng strategy call, as an introvert, napakahirap sa akin mag-hop on a call. Yun yung, kumbaga sabi nga nung coaches ko or mentors, kapag nalagpasan mo yung una, parang padali na lang naman ang padali. So, yun yung, I think, sa akin na pinaka-accomplishment ko. Kasi the rest is parang, yung, yun nga, pag sa freelancer, masasanay ka, hindi naman sa pagmamayabang, di ba? Parang yung feeling mo na, oh, na-overcome ko na yung pinaka-mahirap. Ano pa yung mga susunod? So, feeling ko yun.
Agree.
Agree ang mga fellow introverts dito.
Oh, so, viewers na, may introverts po kami. Akala nyo lang, hindi. ayan. Sige, dako tayo sa medyo deeper questions na may faith. Ayan. Have there been challenges in your freelancing journey that led you to spiritual growth? If yes, can you share? Yeah.
Actually, nung ano po siguro, last year, December, kasi parang feeling ko, kina-question ko kung tama ba yung path na tinaha ko, which is, I think, very normal. Pero ang nangyari sa akin is, yun nga, ang daming noises sa paligid. Parang unconsciously na-affect pala ako. So, after noon, nag-step back ako and then I literally prayed every night. Parang give me signs na this is for me. And ayun nga, parang may divine intervention na basta okay sa'yo, okay sa parents mo, okay na. Ano pa yung bakit ka naguguluhan? Masyado kang focus sa external noises, which is okay naman sa parents mo, okay naman sa'yo. Meron lang parang bumulong. Ewan ko kung naniniwala yung iba sa ganun, pero I think meron talaga in an unexpected way. Ganun.
Hindi naman bulong na literal yan. Ano?
Hindi naman. Nararamdaman.
Ayan.
Oh, pag yun na, magandang ano yun, magandang practice, di ba? Pag kunyari na-overwhelm kayo mga kapatid, step back, pray, connect. Yun yung ano, yun yung magbibigay sa atin ng clarity minsan. Yung imbis na ipilit natin yung sarili natin to stay in a situation na alam natin na hindi na tayo comfortable, baka yun yung time na ini-invite tayo to step back muna para mas makita natin yung bigger picture. Thank you for sharing, Miss Hannah. Magandang ano yun.
Tsaka minsan talagang ano talaga, silence. Silence kasi super noisy nga naman talaga. Ayan. Ito pa isang question. Does your faith influence your decision-making process as a freelancer, such as choosing the right clients or projects you take?
Actually, yes. Parang meron tinuro din sa amin na ano, parang checklist, parang non-negotiable sa client. At the same time, you manifest it. Na sana magka-vibe kayo nung client. Kaya mahalaga yung parang discovery call kung familiar yung mga freelancers doon. Na mafe-feel mo naman yun kung same wavelength kayo. Same beliefs, same values. Kung ito bang client na to, mataas magbigay pero micromanagement yung style niya. Parang ganun. Or meron naman yung utusan ka lang niya pero hindi kanya nakikita as expert. Ganun. Parang yun nga, pinipray ko kung hindi para sa akin, hindi para sa akin. Kasi meron at meron makakakita ng worth ko. Yun na lang yung pinagaano. Hindi ko masyadong sinestress out na. Yun din yung isang tinuro sa amin na mindset shift na huwag maghabol nga sa clients. Kung para sa'yo, para sa'yo. Kung yung sa call, enjoy mo lang. Yun yung pinakaano ko.
Oh, parang lately naririnig natin yan, no? Pero i-add ko lang, ma side note lang, parang relationship lang yan, may checklist ka rin. Non-negotiables at non-negotiables. At kung hindi para sa'yo.
Oo, parang ano. Parang ano, di ba, yung mga there are many fishes in the ocean. Di ba, ganun, ano. Na dapat hindi tayo mag-settle na parang feeling natin, eto na lang yung natitirang client sa mundo. Hindi ganun ang atake natin sa bawat discovery call.
Yes po. Kasi I think kapag wala yung faith, parang madali ako ma-stress out na bakit hindi ko na-close, pero kung pinagpaubaya mo sa kanya na baka hindi para sa akin, baka may mas better.
Yes.
Mas madali ko siyang natanggap. Kaya yun yung pinaka role ng faith dun sa part na yun.
Ganda.
Yeah, thank you for sharing. Oh. So, sa mga kapatid, faith, parang paano ba sabihin yan? Minsan kasi laging pinipilit natin yung ano yung nakikita natin eh. Kung ano yung nakokontrol natin eh. Pero kapag inano mo yung pinractice mo yung faith mo, nagdasal ka, sinurrender mo kay God, ayan na nga. Hindi, it doesn't mean na wala tayong gagawin na. Ayan, may mga discovery calls tayo, ganyan. Eto naman, have you encountered any conflicts between your faith and the work you do as a freelancer? If wala naman, if yes, how did you handle those conflicts?
I think I'll go back dun sa sinabi ko po kanina. Yun lang po kasi yung pinaka-struggle ko. I think, kung sa time na nawalan ako ng faith sa sarili ko, para akong nawalan ng faith sa kanya. Parang yun kasi yung nakikita ka. So, ang ginawa ko nun, yun nga, nag-step back ako. Tapos, hinayaan kong damdamin yung nararamdaman ko kasi parang feeling ko na overwhelmed din ako. At the same time, may ginawa naman ako. So, this past 3 months of 2024, ang ginawa ko is nag-try ako maghanap ng other mentors na makaka one-on-one coaching ko. At the same time, I tried to apply sa agency para mas matuto. Parang kasi feeling ko, nagkaroon ako ng, parang feeling ko, kahit na alam ko lahat ng strategies, wala yung tiwala ko sa sarili ko. Ganun yung nangyari. So, ang nangyari naman is, nagulat ako, natanggap ako out of 100 plus na applicant. So, now I'm currently working under agency. Parang, I think, yun yung naging sagot niya. Nung time na tinatanong ko yung sarili ko, tinatanong ko siya na tama ba na nandito ako, na parang feeling ko walang nangyari, balik na lang ako sa corporate or mag-corporate na lang ata ako. Parang, yun nga, sabi ko merong answer siya sa iba't ibang paraan. So, yun, isipin mo, out of 100 plus ako yung natanggap. At the same time, kasabay nun is, nag-message sa akin si, sorry, I forgot the name.
Christel.
Christel. Yes, si Christel. So, sabi ko, may naniniwala pala sa akin, parang ganun. Like, yun yung way niya of telling me na you're in the right path. Yun.
So, imagine yung timing, ano?
No po.
About freelancing, tapos yung faith, ang galing.
Oo, diba?
Christel, spirit-led.
Yes.
Angel.
Ayan, one last question siguro before our main topic for today's session. So do you have a specific prayer or ritual that you do before starting your online work or a new freelancing project?
Siguro every morning lang po, meron po akong maliit na amulet po. Wala po kasi sa tabi ko dahil room po ng kapatid ko to. Pero maliit po na rosary, parang anklet po siya. Souvenir po siya din sa birthday nung lola ko, which is 74 years old na siya ngayon. So, merong maliit. And then hawakan ko lang na thank you for this day. Ganun lang po kaikli. Pero yung one sentence na yun, I think ang dami ng meaning. Thank you for making my family healthy, parang lahat na po nandun eh. Kaya I made it simple para kahit anytime pwede ko siyang mahawakan or pwede ko siyang masabi.
Yeah. So yan, punta ko na tayo sa main topic for today's session, which is how to never run out of content ideas
or social media? Sige, Hannah, take it away. Backstage lang kami.
I'll just turn off my camera para mas sana okay na yung connection. I'll just share my screen now.
Sige, try natin. Mga kapatid, ask lang kayo ng questions if you're here. While Hannah is preparing, mukhang may slides pa siya. Thank you for preparing. Tapos, ayun lang. Comment kayo. If you're watching on a replay, we still invite you to ask your questions para i-relay na lang namin kay Hannah. Sige, mag-backstage muna kami. Lies kami bang madidistract lang kami sa tungin?
Okay na po. Nakikita po yun. So, ayun. Our topic is how to never run out of content ideas for your social media. So, this is the summary of the presentation. So, number one, reason why you're running out of content. Number two, what are content pillars? Number three, how to identify your content pillars. And four, yung mga examples. So, this may be the reason why you are running out of content. So, example, you're a social media manager and you use educational, promotional, relatable, motivational as your content ideas or your to spark content ideas for your content. So, another example is you're a skincare brand and you use memes, quotes, skincare tips and motivational as the primary basis to create your content. So because of this, you may be having a hard time coming up with content ideas for a month because so actually these are not content pillars. So what are content pillars? So content pillars are or what we call content buckets are 3 to 5 topics that you discuss in depth in your social media. So, yung content pillars, it helps you focus on relevant topics for your target audience. It's either they educate, entertain, or even answer questions. So, content pillars also help in the consistency in your messaging that will eventually build your authority. At the same time, it gives you that clarity on what will you cover or talk about. So having said that, how can we identify your content pillar? So number one, expertise. Number two, target audience and target market. Number three, business offers. So you can answer the following questions under expertise or under target audience to identify your content pillars. So as an example, let's take the previous slide or example a while ago. So you thought that content pillars are educational, promotional, relatable, motivational, but they are called content types. So here's an example of correct content pillars. So, example, your niche is social media manager. Then here's the content pillar. This is based from what I've said earlier, yung expertise, yung target audience and target market, and yung business offers. So, ito yung na-come up ko na content pillars. So, engagement, tools I use as SMM, content creation, hashtags. So, if you already have your content pillars, pull out each content pillar and generate subtopics. So this is the subtopics I generated for content pillar 1, which is yung engagement. So ito siya, same lang to. So, do's and don'ts in engaging, where to engage, best time to engage, engaging with product-based and service-based brands, FB engagement versus IG engagement. Again, ito yung subtopics. So, this is the subtopics I generated for content pillar 2. So, Yung content pillar 2 natin is tools I use as SMM. And then ito yung mga subtopics under content pillar. So, ito yun. So, for content scheduling, for hashtag research, for graphic design, for video editing, for client invoice. Next, this is the subtopics I generated for content pillar 3, which is yung content creation kanina. And these are the subtopics. Content creation system, how to build authority, content calendar template, content graphics checklist, and content hooks. And lastly, yung last content pillar, this is the subtopics I generated for content pillar 4, which is hashtags, do's and don'ts for hashtags, how to research hashtags on IG, how to research hashtags on FB, types of hashtags, and different hashtag sizes. So until you came up with this topic, so ito yung pinaka-summary. So imagine you already generated 20 content ideas from that. Also, if you can notice, you start with general topics, which is your content pillars. And then that's the time you generated specific topics or the subtopics. So just a quick recap, your niche again, for example lang, you are a social media manager. And then your content pillars are engagement, tools I use as SMM, content creation, and hashtags. And then, you have there the subtopics. So the next one is, from these 20 subtopics, just choose one and then choose a content type. Example, so you chose where to engage, which is a subtopic. So a content you can create is educational, and your content is about a list of where to engage on Instagram. So with the same content, you make it as reels, carousel, and single image. So that's a different content format. Tapos, iisa lang yung topic. Same yung topic, but reels format siya, carousel, or single image. Then you can also post it in different platforms where you are focused. So for example, focus ka sa Facebook, IG, TikTok. So imagine isang subtopic lang yun, ang dami na niyang na-generate. So another example, if hindi pa masyadong clear. So this time you chose the content type relatable. So same subtopic pa rin. And your content is about being frustrated because you do not know how to start with your engagement on Instagram. So for Reels, for example, you film a POV where you're sad because your post does not have enough likes, comments, saves, unlike your competitors. Then for Carousel, you included that you were also struggling with engagement when you are starting. And in the next slides, you showed your insights, and that's relatable. For single image, pwedeng gumamit ka ng GIF or yung GIF na tinatawag, na parang nakatulala ka lang, and then relatable siya dun sa mga market or sa target audience mo. Then you have the caption, hoping your ideal clients will engage to your content just because you posted 7 times a week. Then from that, you can post each content format to different platforms. So imagine Reels, FB, IG, TikTok, and then another carousel, which is halos same lang yung content idea, pero iba't ibang format, and then distributed with different social media platform. So imagine if you did this to the other 19 subtopics that you have. So you have a ton of content ideas already. So as a summary, you will never run out of content ideas for your social media. So tip ulit is identify your niche. So in this example, you are a social media manager. Have your content pillars, which is yung medyo general topic. Just choose 3 to 5 general topic or content pillars. So ito yun in this case. And then generate subtopics for each content pillars. And then utilize each subtopics and decide content types, content formats, and post it to different platforms. So you can also add other content pillars in the following months and just repeat the process. So that's it for our topic. If you have questions, you may drop it in the comments or you may follow me in the social media platforms. So thank you very much and I hope you learned something.
Yay! Thank you!
Sobrang helpful indeed.
Nasaan ka na, Hannah? Ayan, grabe ngayon ko lang na ano yung may pillar pa pala yung social media, no? Tapos yung hashtags, importante pala yon. Sorry naman, hindi talaga. Yeah, thank you for sharing. Ayan, connect na kayo kay Hannah. Shinare niya na yung mga socials niya. So go ahead and connect with her. So Sis Bell, your turn.
Yes, so now we go to the fast Q&A round, our fun round, para mas makilala pa natin si Miss Hannah through her answers. Kala mo naman, ano eh, no? Sobrang lalim nung... Pero ito yung fun round lang, parang keep to keep lang. Kasi kanina medyo heavy ang ating mga questions. So this time, let's start our fast Q&A round. So first question, reading or listening?
Listening.
Diet or exercise?
Diet.
Texting or calling?
Calling.
Do you sleep with lights on or lights off?
Lights on pero dim.
What would you do if you won ₱1,000,000?
Wow. Siguro first, secure an emergency fund, and then parents, and then charity.
The last book that you've read or is still reading?
How to Win Friends and Influence People.
Ooh, classic. The top 3 people that you follow?
Local na lang siguro, Hannah Feliciano, wait, ang dami. Ano rin pumasok sa isip ko? Yes, social and skill with Zai.
Okay. Your favorite day of the week?
Monday.
Your favorite place that you've been to?
Bohol.
Wow.
Oh, speaking.
Alala ko nga. Please naman.
Medyo controversial.
Yeah.
No. Ang Bohol.
Actually, may side story. Parang inaano nila, technical nila na hindi naman daw Chocolate Hills yun. Anyway. Your favorite childhood TV show?
TV show? Hannah Montana.
Bakit kaya?
If
you could travel to any place on earth, where would you go?
Israel.
What is prayer to you?
Prayer is a private conversation with God.
Do you have a go-to worship song? If so, please share it with us.
Hindi nakakantahin, di ba?
Touch the Sky. Ano?
Touch the Sky.
Awesome.
Yeah. And then, ask permission or beg for forgiveness?
Ask permission.
Last but not the least, if you could have a face-to-face conversation with God and ask Him one question or say one thing, what would it be?
Thank you for this day.
Aww, Thank you. Thank you. Talagang consistent siya sa pagiging ano, eh, no? Grateful and all. Eh. Thank you, Miss Hannah. So that concludes our fast Q&A round.
Yes. Thank By the so way, much. Sabi pala nung isa may nag-comment, sabi ni Justin T.Y. Hannah. Ayan. Any last piece of advice sa ating mga aspiring, lalo na yung mga nasa social media ang naiisip na i-offer?
Sa mga aspiring freelancer, I feel you. pero merong mga available free resources sa YouTube. Second, you can join free Facebook groups. Marami ng webinars. And then you can check out their guide section. As in, meron ng a detailed na mga guides dun sa mga Facebook groups. But if you want mentorship, talagang kung gusto talaga may paraan tulad nung ginawa ko, so pwedeng pag-ipunan pero not to the point na i-exhaust mo lahat ng meron ka. Kasi as long as may free resources, yun mo na yung gamitin mo.
Speaking of resources, meron ka bang? Ay, sorry. Go ahead.
Sorry. Add ko na rin yung sa mga aspiring freelancer na meron ng existing knowledge pero hirap pang mag-apply. Take action. I-execute mo na yung strategies na alam nila bago mag-jump from one course to another, because based from experience, meron kasing iba na kaya nilang mag-aral ng sabay-sabay and then execute. But if you think na you're a type of person na hindi kaya, na overwhelm agad, tapusin mo muna and then jump to another course or dun ka makinig ng mga other webinars.
Yeah. Yes. Minsan kahit naman kaya mo lahat ng course, feeling ko by the end of it all, ano kaya, mas taka kasi grabe, information overload ito. Ano, based on experience yan mga kapatid, kasi kaming lahat ay na biktima ng shiny object. So anything pala na you'd like to promote, Hannah?
I think na-flash ko na kanina dun lang sa mga social media. For Facebook, Hannah Tobias. Instagram, Step Up Socials. TikTok, it's Hannah Tobias. And then you can wait for upcoming freebies about Instagram content strategy.
Ayun. Connect na. Alam ko na nalagay ko rin yung links niya sa description. So go ahead and visit that. And again, kahit na replay kayo nanonood, if you're watching on a replay, you are still free to share your thoughts, to ask your questions to Hannah. Tapos i-relay namin yung mga questions na yun sa kanya. Ayun. Again, if you want some guidance on how to start your virtual assistant business, feel free to visit connyzabala.com/VABook. Ayan. Mag-closing prayer tayo muna. Wait lang ah. Let's remember that we are in the presence of God. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord, for another episode done successfully. Thank you for the opportunity to share our knowledge and experience to serve our clients. Hopefully, our fellow service providers were able to learn something too. Thank you for all the people who support us in our mission. Thank you for the chance to bless others through this platform. We lift up to you all our viewers, our listeners, our clients, the people we work with, Hannah and her family, and their loved ones. Continue to bless them in all areas of their lives. Whatever their petitions are right now, we pray with them, believing that whatever happens, you always have the best intentions for us. We lift up to you all these, but in the end, your will be done. In Jesus' name, amen. Name the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Ayun, mga kapatid, kita-kita tayo sa Monday for another live praise and worship session. Or if not, sa Thursday ulit. Pero join na kayo ng Monday para pare-pareho maganda ang week natin. Anyway, Hannah, stay ka muna after the live session. Again, for our viewers, feel free to ask your question. If you haven't done so yet, subscribe na and click the bell so that you'll get notifications. We usually go live Mondays, Thursdays, 9 p.m. Manila time. Any last messages, Belle, before we end?
yun, sa execute. Yun lang, ano lang, iniulit ko lang yung message na yun. Huwag masyado mag-overthink, mga kapatid. Just start.
Yes, so that's it for us. Bye, everyone. God bless.
Thank you.
Thank you, Hannah.